All right, we're still going to go at NetApp about this concept of NetApp being a storage dinosaur. Seeking Alpha called them a storage dinosaur. I have the VP of engineering on, and we're just going to go right at it. What has NetApp done to shed this moniker that they've been attributed to it? Are they actually innovating, or is it a retread of what we've seen from NetApp over the past 20 years? Stay tuned for this episode of the CTO Dose. Hey, it's Keith Townsend from the CTO Advisor, and you're watching continued coverage of the NetApp Build Day event. We're here in Boulder, Colorado, and joining us is VP of Engineering, Anil Gaur. We are going to jump right into the area that you're responsible for, HCI, SolidFire. I think one of the things that executives questioned when they saw NetApp entering the HCI arena was, you know what, NetApp is a storage company. They don't sell compute. Like, explain that to me. How is NetApp, who a company that doesn't sell, traditionally sell compute, entering a space that looks at this whole thing as a collapsed unit?
So, Keith, let me put this in perspective. You know, the entire industry is going through a transformation, digital transformation. NetApp is on that journey too. Many years ago, we realized the strategic importance of cloud. We created three business units so we can be very, very focused on the cloud business. And the strategy is working really, really well.
So I talked to the founder of NetApp, David Hitt, maybe about a year, year and a half ago at NetApp Insight. And one of the things he said about the culture of NetApp is that you guys lean into disruption. It's not one of those things, you know, if you think the cloud is going to eat the NetApp business, then you lean into cloud. And it seems to be with NKS and HCI and HCI kind of leading the cloud management plane that you guys are doing that. However, when I read headlines, like the Seeking Alpha headline that says NetApp, storage dinosaur, what's your reaction to that? Like, what do you see the innovations in NetApp?
So you're right. So NetApp has been known as a leader in storage for a really, really long time. And we are bringing all the benefits, you know, to the cloud now. Cloud is the front and center of our strategy. Every new feature, every new service we build, we think cloud first. But we don't stop there. We understand that while the industry is moving towards cloud, every enterprise is at a very different place in this journey. And there are some customers who are just not ready for putting their data or their mission critical applications on the cloud. So while they like all the benefits of the cloud, but they want to keep it hosted in their own data centers. Our strategy is very unique, where we provide a unified view of all the major hyperscalers. So if you use our services, whether you are on Azure, Google Cloud, Amazon Cloud, you get the same experience. And by the way, you have the same experience and abilities on-prem. We treat NKS on HCI as just another region that can be deployed to. So we bring basically all the simplicity, elasticity, you know, flexibility of cloud to all these hyperscalers and to on-prem customers.
So we had Adam Carter, chief architect for HCI on. We've had Rob Ecker, the product manager for NKS on. And they did a really great job of explaining the technology, the why NetApp is doing this. I think one of the things that helps to validate that or even test it is to put this thing to the test. How big of an effort is HCI at NetApp? We're in timing can be debatable. The former offices of SolidFire is, and I feel the vibe of a cloud type company. However, give me some idea of scale. How big is the organization dedicated towards HCI?
HCI is one of the most strategic area for us, and this is the fastest growing business. I joined here about a year ago, and the team is growing at a crazy pace. So it's all about, you know, dealing with all the challenges and scaling up fast. Our strategy is resonating really well with the customers. As I said before, you know, people like the benefits of the cloud, but they like it on their own data centers. So we have this unique proposition that where we bring all these benefits on-prem, where you don't need to worry about security if you care so much, you can control. If your needs grow, you can burst into cloud. No need to retrain, relearn anything. Again, the same UI that you use to kind of scale up, down. You can use public cloud for testing, bring it back, you know, to on-prem for production deployments. So that's a very unique value prop, and we are growing really, really fast.
So we want to, and I think I can validate that with some points. Our sponsor had mentioned that you guys are actually moving some folks out of this space, which you guys have a couple of floors here, to move more people in. So the group is growing. I'll give you guys that. But I want to probe, I think, the organization a little bit more, because NetApp has been around for a long time. And one of the things that Dave commented on last year was that change can be resistance. You know, when Dave was an active part of the NetApp community, he was kind of the cheerleader for cloud is okay. It's okay to put ONTAP on the cloud. It's okay to have HCI. It will not kill the company. As a big personality like Dave exits the company, how do you guys keep that momentum? How do you keep that spirit of innovation?
So what keeps NetApp going is our passionate talent that we have. We really enjoy disrupting the world. And with HCI, you know, that's one of the recent example I can give, we have actually disrupted the industry. We have changed the definition of HCI. It's hybrid
cloud infrastructure. With a lot of pushback,
Yeah, and some of the analysts that did not believe in it, they're pleased to see over the year, you know, they've created new category, and there is a new class, disaggregated HCI, which mm-hmm. is a huge win. And the disaggregated HCI allows us to scale independently, you know, compute and storage, which matters a lot at large scale. So those are the things where we bring innovation in a different domain, but it's the passion, it's the technical skills, you know, when you put them to the challenge, solving new problems, we have been great at it. We have proven over and over.
I'm getting the hook, but I'm going to ask you the question about Data Fabric. When I first heard the concept, loved it. But when I saw the NetApp portfolio, I didn't see a coherent strategy. This was maybe about three or four years ago. Update me. Where are you at with this Data Fabric concept?
So Data Fabric concept born like in cloud a few years ago. And today, this is very, very real. We have cloud services, the unified view running in public clouds. And what we are doing, what my organization is responsible for, is to bring all the benefits of Data Fabric architecture and concept to on-prem in a seamless way, where to the end customers, it doesn't matter, you know, where they're running the data or applications, whether it's all about, you know, scaling, whether it's about backups, recovery, data tiering, because, you know, at large scale, if you keep everything together in one place, can be very, very expensive. So all those things put together, including disaster recovery, it's a very unique, you know, strategy that NetApp offers.
So I'm looking forward to the Build Day Live videos and having Alistair and team put this concept to the test. We had Robert Echo on earlier, and he talked through how a developer would experience NKS and not have to actually see the behind the scenes and use it in the native way that they can, and how operators can still use ONTAP and the things that they love. Well, we'll see. Well, I'd love to hear your feedback. Comment in the section below, or you can hit me up on Twitter at CTO Advisor. Of course, on LinkedIn, you can find both me and Anil. Talk to you next, CTO Dose.